What is up? Ass here once again. Today we have a couple of news and updates in the game for you. As you can see here from this purple glowing portal, the 2x Void Summon event has started. Make sure that whenever you summon, the Epic and the Legendary have the increased chances. I already summoned my Void Shards. Unfortunately, I got nothing, but that's fine because I have a lot of champions that I still need to build. In other news, we currently also have the Spider Tournament and the Arena Onslaught Tournament going on. From the Spider Tournament, you can get Frozen Banshee, so this is your number one priority if you don't have this champion, because she is used in the fusion and overall a great champion. I'm almost there, and I'm tempted to stay below this guy just to get the Relentless gear, but I'm not sure about that yet. The Arena Onslaught Tournament, I already claimed all the rewards, and as you can see, my group is fairly competitive and I don't have the resources to go any further, but that's fine for me. I have a compilation of clips to show you afterwards from this tournament. I used a speed clearing team to farm as many medals in a short amount of time with using the least amount of resources available. Beginning from yesterday, we also have the Artifact Enhancement event going on. In this event, you can also get access to the Twin Claw Disciple and the Beast Wrestler. The other rewards are fairly good, and if you can, you should get as many points as possible. Make sure to conserve your silver, because there is another Artifact Enhancement event coming soon. As mentioned earlier, I went ahead in the arena and started with a speed farming team to gain as many points as possible in a short amount of time. This is the team I'm currently using. Skullcrown as a lead, Apothecary, Sinesha, and Draco more for the defense down. This team works pretty well. Let me quickly go over the stats that I'm currently using on these champions. As you can see, my Sinesha has around 3.4k attack, 186 speed, 100% crit rate, 236% crit damage. This is by far not the best. As you can see, my artifacts are still lacking. I still need to get access to a way better attack percent chest, but that's what I'm dealing with now. Sinesha stats: 2100 attack, 170 speed, 79% crit rate, 166% damage. She's currently using a cruel set and an offense set. Some pretty good crit damage here, other than that, nothing else. An attack chest, crit damage gloves that still need to be upgraded, I was just lacking the silver. Pretty decent shield, an okay helmet, and a decent weapon as well. My next champions are Dracomorph. He's having 2300 attack, 204 speed, low crit damage and low crit rate because I'm still using him for other content where I need his survivability higher, but once I get his stats pumped up, then he will also be a supporting damage dealer. And lastly, my Apothecary. The only important stat here is the speed, 243. That's still slow as I'm still building up my speed gear. He has decent crit rate, which helps with his heals. Let's quickly go over my Great Hall. As you can see, I'm still working on the mission, so there's my priority, where accuracy will be my number one that I get to 10, and the rest is very mediocre. So over the next couple of weeks, I will try to get them to level 4 at least, especially crit damage, because that will help me overall the most. And now, without further ado, let's go into the compilation. I hope you enjoyed this highlight reel. That wasn't all the fights, just the more interesting ones. And that's all I have for you today. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. See you in the next one, and until then, peace!